to Through the Bible. Let us begin our next book from the Bible, the book of Nehemiah. Our story today is titled, The Walls of Jerusalem Were Built. Nehemiah chapters 1 and 2. While Ezra the priest was teaching the people of Jerusalem the law of God, another man was leading them in the work of building up the city walls. This man was Nehemiah, who had been a very important officer in the palace of the king of Persia. He was the cupbearer of King Artaxerxes and a very faithful Jew. Nehemiah was living in Susa many years before, taken as captive by the Babylonians. When the Medes and Persians defeated the Babylonians, many Jews like Nehemiah resettled in this new empire. The news reached Nehemiah by one of his brothers of the very unhappy condition of his people in Jerusalem. He heard that the city walls were broken down and that the gates had been burned, and that the people were living in great poverty. When this news came to him, Nehemiah mourned and fasted and prayed that God would forgive his people for their sins and show him how to help them. In the course of his duties, Nehemiah went in to serve the king, and the king noticed how sad he looked. He asked Nehemiah to tell him what was wrong. When he explained his troubles to the king, Artaxerxes asked how he could help. Nehemiah sent up a little prayer to heaven and then asked the king to give him permission to go to Jerusalem to his people there. Would the king send messengers to the governors of the provinces along the way to help him and enable him to get safely to Jerusalem? The king and the queen gave him permission to go and allowed him to go to Asaph, the controller of the royal forests, to obtain from him all the timber he would need for the building work in Jerusalem. Then, with a little party of horsemen and a large party of Jews who wanted to go back to Jerusalem, Nehemiah began the journey of nearly 1,000 miles through the desert. When the nobleman reached Jerusalem, he did not at first tell the people why he had come. For 3 days he remained there very quietly, and then one night, with a few men, he slipped out secretly to inspect the walls and gates of the city. When he had seen clearly the ruined condition of all the walls and gates, he went back to his lodging. The next day he went to the nobles and priests and rulers and told them his plans for the rebuilding of the wall. He explained how God had answered his prayers and how King Artaxerxes had promised to help. Then the people took heart and said, "Let us begin with the work." Every family in the city had its part in the work. Each one had its section of the wall to do or its gate to build, and each set to his task with a will. It did not matter how noble the people were or what kind of work they did. All joined in building the city wall. There was great enthusiasm, and all looked forward to the finishing of the work and the safety of Jerusalem. But there were some people who were very angry at what happened. Sanballat the Horonite and Tobiah the Ammonite and Geshem the Arabian first jeered at the people of Jerusalem and then tried to hinder the work. Sanballat laughed and said, "The Jews would never be able to make a wall out of the heaps of rubbish in Jerusalem." Tobiah said that if a fox leant against their wall, it would fall over. But the Jews kept on building the wall.